Hello everyone, and welcome to a new episode of The Palace. So, I'm glad you guys are back to watch this again. Today we have quite something special. A big amphitheater like the Greeks and Romans used to have, only not Greek and Roman, it's actually from the Baroque times. I don't know, they were like, in the summer, the royal family could have like plays, and they would invite artists, and they would watch with all their elites and VIP guests in the summer in a nice wind and breeze. But then the monarchy got disbanded, or what would you call that? It was a revolution, and that's when the zoo started in our lore of our little park. And that's the amphitheater was abandoned and it was that laid there to rot. But then, when there were a lot of new animals added to the zoo, they thought, hey, we could use this amphitheater to have some fun and use it as theming for our lion habitat. Wouldn't that be cool to have like lions laying on like steps of the amphitheater? Yeah, that's what I thought too, and that's why I'm making one here. And in the end, it's really nice. You guys seen it in the preview. I'm really happy with the results. What a great opportunity, isn't it? Yeah, okay, so here I'm building the amphitheater, and it was a very slow and tedious process of rotating a piece, then copying it, and then rotating it again and again and again, and it was really, really tedious, so I cut it all out for you people. Isn't that nice? If you want me to cut more stuff out of my videos that isn't nice to watch, subscribe to me, that would be nice. Yeah, I was being stupid. I was like copying every single one of them, and then in the end I just figured out that hey, I could copy like three of them and do it thrice as fast. So I did that, and you see me going down each step here. I didn't want it to be too big. I wanted to be in scale of the park and not like overshadow it, because there are some huge amphitheaters out there. But I didn't want that for the palace zoo. So I'm keeping it like reasonably small, but still big enough that it could be an actual theater and people would have sat there in the past, and now lions walk over it. Now in the game the lions can't really sit on the steps because it's too small and it's not climbable, but I fixed that with adding some platforms, some scaffolding where they can lie on and take a nice bit of sunbathing. Yeah. But that's gonna be constructed later, and they can climb down that as well. I thought that was pretty cool, and it all adds to the story of the amphitheater being renovated and the lions took over. I don't know, some stuff like that. But I thought it would be a cool addition to the park, and also lions by themselves are pretty cool to have in your park. So I'm glad that's finally they're finally here. The habitat itself isn't gigantic or anything, but it's really narrow, but long. I thought it was interesting because then people would have like a big path to it, and there's lots of viewing area, and I think that turned out well too. I also did a bit more terrain work this episode. You saw me do that in the first few seconds, but that was fun because I haven't done a lot of terrain work here, only the precise stuff, but I want some more verticality in there, so more ditches, more mountains, well, not mountains, but hills. So this is placed on a hill, and this path is also going to be on a hill, because the other side of the path is going to be the next exhibit of the park, and I don't know what it's going to be yet. Maybe zebras or something, but then again, the lions would be able to see the zebras and think, oh, that's a nice snack, and we don't want that, so maybe a cafe, I don't know, we need to figure this stuff out. If you guys have any recommendations, give them to me. And you can also give them to me, the Discord server. Yeah, we started the Discord server, which is pretty active actually. So we talk about the game here and the zoos and your zoo and this and that. And we give each other suggestions on what we can build. So if you want to be a part of that, there's a link down in the comments. Some people of the Discord server gave me some tips for this episode. So that's really fun. It's a really active feedbackism community. Yeah, so more terrain here, and deleting some trees. And I only wanted to use natural borders for this side of the habitat, Because fencing would look out of place, I felt like that. So I used a null barrier here. I'm finally getting the hang of how it all comes together. Yeah, it's a nice tool. If now I know how to work it properly. But then again, yeah, I'm working with the terrain tool, and the terrain tool is still not that good. So, well, it's decent if you. Oh no, it's not decent. I'm gonna make a video with how I think it would be better. But oh my god, the square tool for the terrain is really good. So I'm glad they added that. Because we didn't have that in Planet Coaster, but that's for precision stuff. But still, the combination of paths and terrain tool is abysmal. Or I'm just not using it correctly. That might also be a thing. I need to do some research. Because I want to, like, if I want to work with terrain a lot more, you know, I need to step up my effort. And try to actually come up with some cool stuff. And here, we're back with the Rocky Rocks. Famous guest of our show. A sponsor of the last episode. And they're back again. Only this episode is not tropical rocks, but it's temperate rocks. Wow, such diversity. Such, diversity in our episodes. Isn't that great? We're very progressive here at the Palace Zoo. You're gonna see me placing a lot of rocks. And that's pretty fun, right? Yeah. If you want to see me placing more rocks, again, subscribe. It's been ridiculous, by the way, on my channel lately. The crosswalk video has like 16k views out of nowhere. That's great. I'm glad people enjoyed them. Hello, new people. My name is Jure. I play this game and Planet Coaster 2, even though that isn't that popular anymore, but I really enjoy that too. So yeah, if you like semi-realistic stuff and architecture and animals, then yeah, watch my content. Welcome to this wholesome community, this magical place. I'm glad to see all these new people coming in. Also, the feedback has been great from the last episode. I'm glad you guys liked that botanical thing, even though it doesn't work. I might be placing some animals in there, some turtles, tortoises, peafowls. What else did they? What else did they suggest? Yes, that's the word. I don't know. We'll see. We will see what will fit there later. But anyway, yeah. I tried to go with a rocky mountain here. Because it would fit well. And not really fit well, but it looks like a proper lion hangout place. Like, hey, Jared Lion, this is Tanner from high school. Would you like to come out, hang out with me on this rocky rock? And then it would all come here, yeah. That's how this works. Yeah, still lots of rocks. Should have cut this out? No, because there's people who are like rockwork, hashtag rockwork people. Rockwork is one of the most essential parts of this zoo. Well, it's part of every habitat. So, never mind that. Here we're constructing nice shadow. Well, it's a nice, used to be some supports for like the drapes that cover you from the sun. Some people in the Discord recommended that, so that's great. And then we are just adjusting it because it's been deteriorated over the time, right? It's a bit fallen down and a bit of a wreck. But they're reconstructing it, that's why I'm gonna build scaffolding in a bit. But yeah, just try to delete some of the supports and then make it like all look torn down. I don't know. Yeah, here's the scaffolding, and I have to be a bit creative here because the lions are a bit buggy when it comes to climbable things, and they're still pretty buggy in the final result of this episode. But hey, they can at least walk over these and lay down, and that's cool. So they actually, people see them laying down on the scaffolding. I thought that was a pretty cool view. Then I did the supports. Yeah, it's just sticks, right? So some sticky sticks under the supports. It was fun. Was it fun? I don't know. I had fun talking to people while doing it. I'm streaming a lot of the what I'm building now in Discord. And I'm in voice chat and I'm playing Planet Zoo. I'm just going to stream it. People can give suggestions live. And I'm actually going to do that on YouTube too, when I figure it all out, how it works, and properly, because I want to do it right. And here, they had some shades, some drapes, to cover the lions from the sun, if they've got it hot, or cold, or I don't know. I thought it was pretty nice. Extended it a bit here. And then I continued on the next day with some more terrain here. I did this today, so that's fun. Okay, some more supports. And of course we need some really sketchy wooden support things for the supports, for the scaffolding. Yes, you see that a lot of the in theme parks and stuff. And in scaffolding, it's hard to do theming because I know lions will be here, so all these like rubble things are glued down or something, or at least the lions can't move them. But I thought it would be interesting to go a bit more into theming, which I want to do the next zoo. I'm thinking about doing a Venice zoo, like with an Italian theme and like kennels and some Italian mountains. Have I already told this? I don't know. But I'm really excited to do that. I've already got the music for the videos and I'm all planning it out a bit. And that's gonna be a bit more focused on architecture too. Venetian architecture and gondolas. And we've got the boat ride in the game, right? So I'm gonna use that. So that's gonna be great. People are gonna get to a boat ride to Venice into the zoo. And then the zoo is a bit more open. I still have to figure out how it will all look. But yeah, that's gonna be maybe a project after the palace zoo, but it's gonna be a long while. I don't know how long we'll continue building on this park. I mean, it's going great and it's people like it, so I mean, well, might as well keep doing it, right? So I'm not gonna place all animals in this zoo, obviously, but at least 10 more episodes or so, I think. Yeah, and then in the end, I'm gonna make a huge interactive tour thing. It's going to be fun and very intensive to build, to make, but I really want to make something cool out of it. And here, the barriers, not the barriers, I said we're not going to use barriers, it's the fence for the guests not to drown in the water and get eaten by lions. Now people may ask, hey, but isn't the fence supposed to be higher? Like, animals, the lions can just climb out of it. And I thought that too, but apparently if you've got like a moat, this is not moat, I don't know. Yeah, if there's like water and the lions can't cross it, then it's supposed to be safe enough because people shouldn't be idiots. And apparently there was a woman in a New York zoo who climbed into the lion habitat and the lion even didn't eat her. So that's great. So I'm not worried about our guests. Also, they can't die in the game. So that's also a thing to take into account. Oh yeah, okay, here's the staff building. Well, the lion holding facility, I guess. So what I did here, I built a cage. Because I watched a video of some zoo in England, and they had this this cage system where the lions could come in and sleep, and I don't know, guests could learn about them from close. So I used the TV stand, New World stand thingies to make a cage shape, and I think it actually worked pretty well, better than I expected. And then just imagine that there's a door in the front. Like, I built some, so that, yeah, that's the door. You saw that? That's the door. Then I did some habitat enrichment. And some door in the back. And Mr. Domez's air ventilation stuff is also still very useful. So I'm glad I got to use that here. Thanks, Mr. Domez. I'll link it down in the description once again. Go subscribe to him, people, on Steam. I don't know if he's a YouTube channel, but his stuff is pretty amazing. And then some concrete for the people to, trip and like fall into the lion habitat. And some rocks, because well, you need rocks. And I tried to loosely theme the building so it doesn't stick out as much. But it's not really themed, it's just a box. But yeah, you know what it's, you're seeing what it's, what I'm going after. Yeah, okay. And some trees in the back here. It exactly borders the greenhouse we built last episode, but people can't get there from here because that's not part of the zoo. That's part of the palace gardens. And that's free, and the zoo is, well, people need to pay for that. Oh, and here we got the cinematics. So there is the lady lion laying around. So I thought, hey, let's do some cinematics again, right? Isn't that fun? Yeah. So this is the end result for now. People can still give feedback, of course. They do walk over the scaffolding, which is nice. And also, I'm playing on Ultra now. Actually, just for the cinematics, and I slowed the game down with a program called Cheat Engine, and then I speed it up twice, so I have this twice the amount of frames for the video. So it isn't laggy, isn't that great? Yeah, the effort I put into this is, yes, okay. So this is the entire view of the amphitheater. Pretty happy with it, to be honest. Might be a bit unrealistic in terms of the danger for the lions, but animal welfare isn't one of our primary concerns. This is Billy the lion, and his wife is called Ria, no, actually it's Anita, yeah, Anita, yeah. Here they are hugging, yeah, and this is the backstage view of the lion. And that's actually already it for this week. So yeah, to join the Discord server, and if you enjoyed the content and want to support the channel, links for that are down in the description. Subscribe to the channel, and yeah, you know what to do. Leave a like, and let me know what you would like to see next in the Palace 2. So, thanks for watching.